The family Cactaceae are incredible plants adapted to the arid conditions of the New World. Most cacti are known for their lack of regular leaves, with special types of leaves forming spines from special bumps called areolas, which are actually a modified branch. These spines protect the cactus from herbivores, as well as provide several important water-conserving services, such as holding moisture around the cactus. Among the thousands of species of cactus, one really stands above the rest, a species that has become what can only be described as a tree, the saguaro. They are endemic to the Sonoran Desert of Arizona, southeastern California, and northern Mexico, where they form strange forests across the desert slopes. Like most other cacti, the saguaro is a stem succulent, which means they use their thick stems as the main place they store water, and their large size allows them to absorb some 760 liters in a single rainstorm they collect with their vast underground root system. Like many other cacti and succulent plants, they have also modified how they photosynthesize. Instead of using the C3 mechanism most other angiosperms use, which lets most of the water in the plant escape because the plant needs to leave the tiny pores on the leaves called stomata open to let CO2 in, cactus have adopted crassulacean acid metabolism, which only opens stomata at night when the temperatures are cooler, and then store the carbon dioxide inside the plant's cells for the day when they can actually do photosynthesis. The saguaro is a keystone species in the Sonoran Desert, with many animals using these plants for food and shelter. The blooms of the saguaro are pollinated by a range of animals, from hummingbirds to bats, with the white-winged dove surprisingly being one of the most important. No animal, though, loves saguaro more than the Gila woodpecker. Not only do they enjoy the flower nectar, but they also like to make their nests inside the cactus, drilling cavities that the cactus forms callus tissue around, creating the perfect little cavity for the woodpecker to raise a family. Each season, the Gila woodpecker creates a new hole, so holes from previous seasons are available for other birds that love the saguaro, but don't have the special drilling beak of a woodpecker like the elf-owl, the world's smallest owl. People like saguaro too, usually, and they are protected under Arizona state law. Some people, though, like to destroy things, and so some people like to shoot at them. People like David Grunman, who in 1982 was trying to bring a saguaro down with a firearm, which he eventually did, but it came down on top of him. This is what is known as natural selection. Though these cactus are adapted to survive in the desert, climate change is making the Sonoran Desert drier, and increased drought will likely stress and kill these cactus at a higher frequency. Thank you for watching this episode. I am trying my best to implement some more videos specifically looking at plants. On this channel, my goal is to create quality short documentaries that educate viewers on the natural world, with the hope that they inspire outdoor exploration and conservation action. If you enjoyed this video, please consider clicking the subscribe button and taking a look at some of my other videos. I would really appreciate it. Bye.